Hey everyone and welcome back. Before we begin here today, please make sure that you like and subscribe because it really does help out our channel and it also helps us reach others in need of assistance with these topics. So today we're going to be looking at calculus and we're going to be looking at our third part of calculating derivatives for simple polynomials. So we're going to be calculating the derivatives for the three expressions shown above. And these three expressions, we are going to be able to solve them using this formula. So we're going to have our ddx, or whatever variable we're taking the derivative of, and we're going to have some kind of constant a times our variable we're taking the derivative of, and it's going to be to some power. So when you take the derivative of an expression that is ax to the b, what happens is that constant remains constant through the derivation, so it remains a, and then you have your x to the original power. Well, you're going to drop that original power of b and multiply everything by that power. And then you're finally going to take the original power of b and minus 1. So with a few of these shown above, we're going to, and in most cases in real world applications, your expressions will not be this simplistic in this form already of ax to the power of b. So you have to turn them into this expression and then solve them using this formula. So let's go ahead and work on that. So number one, we are taking the derivative with respect to x of the expression 5 over x squared. Well, not really in this term of ax to the power of b just yet. So let's rearrange here, because anytime you have x, well, 1 over x to the a, that is simply just saying, got ahead of myself there. That is just simply saying that you have x to the power of the negative a, anytime it's in the denominator. So let's rearrange here, and we're going to take the derivative with respect to x of 5 times x to the minus 2. Now we are in this formula of ax to the power of b, where 5 is a, x is still my variable, and then minus 2 is my power of b. So taking the derivative of this, we're going to keep that constant of 5 there. We're going to have x to the minus 2. And then we're going to take this 2, or this minus 2, and we're going to drop it in front and multiply everything by it. And then we're going to subtract 1 from that power. So simplifying this down a little bit, we have minus 2 times 5, which gives me negative 10. My variable x, and minus 2 minus 1 gives me to the power of negative 3. And you could leave your answer like that, or you could write it as this, minus 10 over x to the power of 3, just getting rid of that negative power, putting it into the denominator here. Either one of these answers is correct for this beginning expression. Just depends on how you want to write. And going through derivatives, you can make your answer super complex, or you can make them as easy as you want. Just depends on how you feel, or more than likely you're doing this for homework or any type of project. And it really depends on who's looking at it, who's grading it, who's the picky one here. So moving on with number 2, we are taking the derivative with respect to x again. And this time we have x, or 8 times x to the power of 7/4. Well, we really don't have to rearrange this one at all because it's already in terms of ax to the power of b, where 8 is my a, x is of course the variable, and then b is 7/4. So let's just go ahead and take the derivative of this. So we're going to remain constant of 8 times x to the 7/4. We're going to take that 7/4 and we're going to drop it and multiply everything by it in the front here, and then subtract off 1 from 7/4. So simplifying this down a little bit, if you take 7/4 times 8, you get 14. We have the variable of x still there. And then 7/4 minus 1 is essentially saying 7/4 minus 4 over 4. And that will give me 3/4. And that's my answer for that. Alrighty, so our next one is going to be the derivative of just u with respect to u. So number three, we are taking d du with respect to just u. Now, there is a shorthand notation for this, and I will show you after we solve it, going through the same method that we just applied to the first two, the longer way. And then I'll show you how we can do this really super quick without this expression of ax to the power of b. Because essentially what we have here, we're taking the derivative with respect to u. That's the variable we're going to replace with x inside of this equation here. And essentially what we have going on here, when you just have a constant, it is 1 times your when you just have a variable, it'll be 1 times your variable to the power of 1. Now it's in terms of ax to the power of b, or just replacing x with u in this case for a variable. So taking the derivative of this expression, we will have our constant of 1 times our variable of u to the power of 1. Take the 1 and drop it in front and multiply everything by 1, and then subtract off 1 from our power, which is essentially 1 minus 1. So what we have going on here is 1 times 1, which is 1, times u to the power of 0. Well, anytime you have a variable to the power of 0, that will just be 1. So even if it was x to the 0, it'd be 1. C to the 0, it'd be 1. Doesn't matter what variable you have, anything to the power of 0 is 1. And that goes with any real number as well. And of course, we can just ignore 1 because 1 times 1 is 1. So that's our answer there. So that was the longer way of doing it. If we want to do it a fast and dirty way, we can do it like this, where we have du times u. Anytime you see a variable with no number attached to it, no power, nothing being done to it, it is just simply a variable. The derivative of a variable by itself will always just be 1. So what if we have a constant attached to that? So let's say we have the derivative of just 5x. Well, it's the same procedure, but instead of being 1 right here, which would be our number, we have 5. It's the same procedure of saying x to the 1, drop it down, 1 times 5 is 5. X to the power of 1 minus 1 gives me 0, which would give me 1 times 5. In the end, it's 5. So anytime you have a derivative being taken and it is just a variable, it will always just be whatever constant's attached to it. If nothing attached to it at all, it's just simply 1. If there's just a simple number attached to it, it will just be that constant number there. So I hope this video was helpful. And if you want to see more problems solved of this variety, please check out other videos on our channel, as we are constantly adding and uploading. Also, if you haven't done so already, please make sure you like this video and subscribe to our channel. Thank you for watching, and I hope you have a fantastic day.